The Union Budget 2018-19 clearly seems to have given into pre-election mode, as is evident from the fact that total expenditure is expected to rise by 14% compared to the budget estimates for the previous year, compared to the 8.5% increase seen for last year. So this is at least a 5 percentage point increase from the previous year. This increase is coming from entirely an expected rise in revenue spending by almost 17%, even while capital spending is expected to decline by 3%. Note that capital spending for the revised estimate of 17-18 is already down by almost 12% compared to the budget estimates. This is explained at least partly by the fact that the government probably wanted to control any further fiscal slippage. If we look at the fiscal deficit to GDP numbers that have been put out, they are now at 3.5% compared to the 3.2% envisaged at the time of the budget last year. And this was largely expected because the growth has not been at par with what was anticipated at that point in time. Also the absolute amount of fiscal deficit is higher than envisaged. But going forward in 18-19, fiscal discipline will be back on track with a 3.3% expectation of fiscal deficit to GDP ratio. This is an important number to watch out for, since it's viewed carefully internationally from the macro stability perspective. There were two announcements that were very important. One was the increase in MSPs to 1.5 times the cost of production. This will impact rural and agricultural incomes positively and thus have an impact on overall consumption spends in the economy as well. It could have some inflationary impact, but how far that plays out remains to be seen. In terms of the second announcement, the National Health Protection Scheme is an important one to watch out for. How it's going to be funded remains to be seen, but insofar as it provides much needed social security to poor and vulnerable families in the economy, it is a scheme worth watching out for. For the MSMEs, the government had a positive announcement in terms of reduction of corporate tax rates for companies with a turnover of up to 250 crores to 25%, up from the turnover of 50 crores as announced last year. So at a time when growth has been slow and cost pressures have been rising, this should be a positive for these companies and for the sector as such. Some other incentives have also been provided in terms of capital support, interest subsidies, as well as employment incentives by providing higher EPF contributions by the government. So these all add up to providing greater support to MSMEs. Overall, the budget is a fair one.